So good evening. My presentation today is about methods of generating solar envelopes using computational design and environmental simulation, and also the description of one optimized method for a complex urban environment. Natural light is one of the main factors for the physiological and psychological wellness of inhabitants of residential premises, and direct solar radiation is the most valuable source of natural light for its quality, quantity, and distribution potentiality. And every country, and sometimes also every city, has its own regulations about the necessary quantity of natural light inside the living premises. And this research is part of a larger work, a larger research about the assessment of the infill potentialities of Soviet era quarters in Tallinn. This is, for example, the quarter of Mustamäe. The regulation in Estonia states that if you build new houses, where other existing housing is already present, this new construction cannot deprive the existing residential dwellings for more than 50% on a daily basis of the direct solar access that this premises receive in a period from 22nd of April to 22nd of August. And this task can be easily, efficiently done using solar envelopes. That means it is possible to calculate what is the maximum buildable volume in the middle of some specific plot in a way that for some specific period and time duration, they don't cast shadow on the surrounding buildings. It is quite an intuitive way that it is possible to. It is also possible to calculate solar envelopes on paper using the solar azimuth and sun altitude, the two angles. But it is a quite tedious and long process, and it can be quite imprecise in urban contexts. Actually, nowadays many CAD. They offer the possibility to generate solar envelopes automatically. And here we have some example. For example, this is Autodesk Ecotect, quite old school software. It is also not in commerce anymore, but it is quite interesting and quite educational. And for example, in this case, the input using this software are the facade of the building that doesn't have to be shaded. The plot on which we want to build, and we have to calculate the solar envelope. And when we give the sun angle, the software automatically generates, in this case, two planes because we were selected two facades that we can use as the limit for the solar envelope on this plot. So quite few input and some elements that we can use in design, but still not very easy to use. Some little bit more advanced tools we find, for example, in Grasshopper. One is Dava for Rhino and Grasshopper. So in this case, the inputs are the contour line at the base of the facade that we don't want are shaded during, in this case, all the year. It is not possible to select some other periods, but we can select the start and end hour for every day. And also, obviously, the most important data to input is the latitude of the location of the buildings. So in this case, you see that the solar envelope is generated that guarantee, in this case, for example, from 10 to 2 for every day to the facade that are facing this red contour. Some other tools, always a little bit more advanced. You can see here, this is always in Grasshopper. This is the environmental design suite Ladybug. In this case, we still input the latitude of the location of the buildings. And then in this case, we can give not only a start and day, start and end hours, but also a start and end day and month. So we can be even more precise for the period. We have always the plot for the solar envelope, and the building is used for the baseline of the facade that state what is the limit that on which the direct solar access has to be guaranteed. Let's say all these methods are efficient if we are trying to calculate the solar envelope for one facade and without any kind of surrounding. But when it comes to more articulated environment, there are some limits. The first limit is given by the start and end hour, because actually when we have a different facade with different orientation, then those should need different start and end hours. And most of all, since we were talking about these regulations that we have in Estonia, that state that the building should receive 50% of what they receive nowadays, in a complex urban environment, we don't really know how much direct solar access hours this facade receives. So how we can calculate the start and day hour? So it should be good if we can or first consider different start and day hours for the different facade, or even better if we can use the actual amount of direct solar access per facade as one of the input to generate solar envelope. And the proposed method actually does this. Consider the actual amount of direct solar access hours and integrate environmental simulation in the computational design environment and the parametric design of the solar envelope and multi-objective optimization. The first step is at first it was isolated one block to make this research, and the area in between is where the solar envelope has to be generated. So on this block, the direct solar access has been calculated by the simulation software. And at the same time, for every node of the different facade has been calculated the minimum, maximum, and average sunlight hours. So for comparison and evaluation of the proposed method, first the solar envelope has been generated using the basic method that we have seen with the tools before. So with this other portion of the algorithm, the minimum amount of direct solar access hours has been isolated for the first floor because it is the one that received the least light. If you guarantee that the first floor received the requested amount, then all the facade would receive the, at least the same amount. And then the 50% has been calculated. In this way, since the first basic method, the use one single start and time, the different start and end time have been used for the different facade and then merged in one single time frame. And the facade baseline of all the facade has been used for the generation of the solar envelope. And so in this first case, let's call it in this existing method, the solar envelope, it is quite small. And in fact, it allows much more than 50% of direct solar access on the surrounding facade. Let's say an advanced procedure of the existing method has been used, let's say, splitting the four facades. So each one of these facades has been, on each one of the facades has been calculated one solar envelope. And then considering the baseline of each facade as the limit to guarantee that specific amount of start and end time. And then with the small algorithm, selection algorithm, actually the point of the same grid with the lower z value have been selected. So again, we have a new solar envelope that is a little bit bigger than the previous one, but still allow more than 50% on the surrounding facade of direct solar access hours. So this is a strong limitation because all these existing method solar envelopes are underestimated, the volume that it is possible to build on this plot. So actually, the proposed method uses the multi-objective optimization of the plugin Octopus for Grasshopper. This is an evolutionary software that look for the best trade-offs between multiple objectives and also during multiple generations with the scope to find the optimal solutions and trade-offs in which the different characteristics, when one is improved, for example, the other is decreased. So the different objective used for the generation of the solar envelope, the main one, the first one actually, is the minimization of the deviation between the minimum direct solar access hours at each iteration of the calculations, so with each solar envelope, with the target one that is the 50% of the required for the regulation. And the second objective was the maximization of the volume of the solar envelope. And the third one actually is the maximization of the sum of the minimum amount of direct solar access each node. And this has been done always on the first floor of the facade. Yes, so those are in graphics, let's say, the three objectives. The minimization of the deviation and the maximization of the volume and also of the total quantity of direct sunlight hours per facade node day. And the solar envelope control point where the four corners of the plot and then the edge point that were free to slide along the edge and they could change the Z value. The corner point, they could only change the Z value. And the internal point could move inside the plot and also change its height, Z value. And so actually the result of the multi-objective optimization is a three-dimensional grid with different solutions from, let's say, the non-dominated Pareto front one that are, in this case, the red cubes, or the elite-dominated that were the previous selected in the generation process that are the transparent red cube, and elite solution discarded from the previous generation that are the yellow transparent cube. So you can see that in this diagram we have on the three axes the three objectives, and we can say that this optimization software doesn't look for just one best solution, but for different, as we said, trade-offs, and then the designer can choose between the different solutions, which one is the most appropriate for the specific design task. So in this case, let's say that the full optimal solution would be the one closer to the intersection of the three axes and objectives, or for each objective, the fittest solution are those that are close to the zero of that specific axis and objective. So for the evaluation of this method, three non-dominated Pareto front have been selected, A, B, and C in this case, and the solutions have been reinstated. That means that the solar envelope have been generated in the 3D space of rhinoceros, and then have been calculated, as we have said, the volume of the solar envelope, then the deviation between the direct sunlight hours of each of these solution and the target one, and also the sum of the total minimum direct sunlight hours. So as it is possible to see, the three solar envelopes generated with multi-objective optimization perform much better than the other methods because the volume is always bigger and the deviations are much smaller than the existing methods. The deviations of the existing methods are just for the fact, as we say, that those allows more light than what it is necessary. And this means that those allows less light than what it is necessary. And also that as the volume increase, then also the deviation increase and the total amount decrease. So we can say that for our test, this solution A, let's say, is the one that perform better than the others because the deviation is the smallest one. The deviation should be zero, actually. So in conclusion, we can say that we've seen that the actual tools for the generation of solar envelope have a limitation, above all when used in a complex urban environment. And in this environment, it is not adequate the use of the start and hours. And the volume of the solar envelope is always underestimated. But if we use these advanced methods that use multiple objectives, we can have higher performance as a solar envelope. And also because it is possible to generate the solar envelope that are, let's say, generated for that specific urban environment. Future work could be test different kind of objective, always related with direct solar access hour and the solar envelope volume. Then increase the number of control point of the mesh of the solar envelope, using in case also agent-based method. And final step would be realize through scripting a new tool to generate solar envelope that take into account all the characteristics of the presented method, but without the necessity to run evolutionary simulations that are time consuming. And that's it. Yeah. Thank you.